Hi everyone, I am R.V. Kiran, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering. Today, in this video lecture, I am going to discuss about a small topic on engineering drawing, and the topic to be discussed are ellipse, and I am going to explain two methods in the construction of ellipse. So there are several methods, but I am going to discuss about only two methods in this video. The first one is the oblong method. It is also known as the rectangle method, and second one is the parallelogram method. So these are the two methods I am going to discuss in this video lecture. So in the previous lecture, we have already discussed about the type of conic sections. So in the type of conic sections, three types of curves have been elaborated. The first one is the ellipse. So we are going to define the different methods in construction of the ellipse today. So these are the construction methods of an ellipse. So to construct an ellipse, we are going to use different types of methods. So these are the six different types of methods we are generally used in a engineering drawing. First one is the oblong method. It is also known as the rectangle method. So in this oblong method, we are going to construct these ellipse in a rectangle. So we can call it as also rectangle method also. Second one is the concentric circles method. So in this concentric circles method, two circles have been elaborated by major axis and minor axis, and from these two circles we are going to construct this ellipse. Next one is the parallelogram method. So the ellipse in this method, the ellipse is constructed by a parallelogram, hence it is called as parallelogram method. And the construction of parallelogram method is similar to the first one, that is oblong method. And fourth one is the arcs of circles method. And fifth one, rhombus method. And last one is the basic locus method, that is we also call it as general method. So this general method can be constructed by using a directrix and focus. So upon the above all methods, general method is somewhat different from the all the above methods. So the construction is totally different. So these are the regular methods we are going to construct an ellipse in these methods only. So for any university, for any college, these are the textbook methods we are going to construct an ellipse. So in these, first one is the oblong method, that is also known as rectangle method. So first one is the oblong method. So here the methods can be explained by using an example problem. So we are taking an example problem here. So the question of the example problem can be seen in the top of the slide. So first of all, I am studying the question clearly and then I am going to explain it. So the question is, draw an ellipse by using oblong method having a major axis of 100 mm and minor axis 70 mm long. So in this oblong method, the question can be defined as the above. In this question, the in place of oblong method, it can be given as rectangle method also. So based upon the paper giver, so paper based on the paper setter, it belongs. So whether it is oblong method or rectangle method, we are going to construct it in the same way, same method. And here the two points, the two main points given are, first one is the major axis and second one is the minor axis. So major axis they are given as 100 mm, and minor axis it is given as 70 mm. So first of all, we are going to draw a linear line, straight line of 100 mm length. So first we are taking the major axis length of 100 mm into a straight horizontal line, and after drawing the horizontal line, name it as AB. So the two endpoints can be named as A and B. So here I am taking A and B. You can take on your wish. So let it as P, Q, R, S or any other thing, but I am taking it as A and B. Next, we are going to take the minor axis 70 mm length. So from the center of the AB line, that is 50 mm, we are taking this minor axis. So it can be seen there. So from the center of the major axis, the minor axis can be drawn as a vertical line, and it can be named as CD. I am taking the line endpoints as CD. So there the matter in the question is drawn in two lines, that is major axis and minor axis. Next, with the help of the ends, we can construct a rectangle there. So we can draw the parallel lines to the AB line and CD line and join these points and intersect these points, and we can make a rectangle there. So this is the first step on constructing an ellipse in the oblong method. So take the AB line, that is the major axis line, which is of 100 mm, and next construct the vertical line CD from the center of the major axis, that is 70 mm, and then construct the rectangle by drawing the parallel lines and intersect it. So next we are going to divide the vertical line and the horizontal line of major axis and minor axis. So you can see there, and name it as 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash and 4 dash. So I am taking 4 divisions here. So the line is divided into 4 divisions there. The vertical line is divided into 4 divisions, and I am taking it as 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash and 4 dash. So the length, the vertical line length is of 35 mm. So the total major axis, minor axis line is 70 mm, but half of the line is 35 mm. So I am dividing the 35 into 4 parts, that is 4 individual parts, 4 equal parts. So name it as 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash and 4 dash. And similarly, divide the AO segment. AO means O is the center of the rectangle, and AO means half of the major axis, that is 50 mm. So we are dividing the 50 mm into same number of parts as we have taken in the vertical line. So the AO can also be divided into 4 equal parts, that is 1, 2 and 3. So mark it as 1, 2 and 3. Then connect the points of the vertical line, that is 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash and 4 dash, to the C point through a straight line. So we are making, drawing here a straight line from 1 dash to C, and next 2 dash to C, 3 dash to C. Anyway, 4 dash to C is already connected. So we are taking these 3 points to the connect C point. And next one is the draw a straight line from D to 1 dash through 1 point. So we are taking 1 point as the intermediate point here and the end point as 1 dash. So intersect the line with the 1 dash C line and it connects there. Then similarly draw the other lines to the 2-3 points also. So D2 2 dash through the 2 point and D2 3 dash through the 3rd point. So there we can connect a 3 points. So in the line 1 dash to C 1 point is there, and 2 dash to C 1 point, and 3 dash to C also 1 point. Then connect these A to C line through these points, and we get a curve there. So these intersection points can be connected by freehand curve only, by not using any scale or any compass. We are drawing it only with our freehand. So connect it with A and C. So A and majorly 3 points in between there, next to the C point. Next, in the same manner, divide the other end also. So now we are going to the second quarter. So the rectangle can be divided into 4 quarters, and you are taking the second quarter here. First quarter had been completed there, and we find a curve there. Next, second curve or second quarter also, we are doing the same procedure only. Divide it into same number of equal parts, that is 4 equal parts taken here, and horizontal lines also divided in the same manner, that is 4 equal divisions. So here the vertical line and the horizontal line can be divided in the same number of equal parts. So some students can be taking the vertical line into 4 equal number of divisions and the horizontal line into 2 or 3 equal divisions. So that is wrong. We are going to take the same amount of equal divisions in the vertical and horizontal lines. So take the same procedure, that is by connecting C with the 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, and then connect the D from the first line, 1 dash line through 1, and 2 dash line through 2, and 3 dash line with the third point. Then we get a 3 points indication there. You can see it in the green color mark. And draw a curve by connecting these 3 points from C to B. So here we completed the half portion of the method, half portion of an ellipse. So we are getting a semicircular ellipse here. Next, draw this to the other two parts also, that is to the BD line and DA line also. We are going to divide the same method there, and these are the procedure for the drawing an oblong method. So construction of oblong method, this is the general procedure here. So the procedure need not to be written in the graph sheet, so it is for the purpose of understanding. So when you are going to listen in the class, some students are not grabbing the all the construction. So when you are free at home, when you see at the procedure, you can remember those points and used it in the construction of oblong method. So these are the general procedure of the oblong method. So first of all, draw a rectangle through the major and minor axis as sides. Next, in this rectangle, draw both axes as perpendicular bisectors of each other. Next, for construction, select upper left part of the rectangle. So we can divide it into vertical small sides and horizontal long sides into same number of equal parts. So here I am taking it as 4 equal parts here, and name them, that is 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash and 4 dash, and next 1, 2 and 3 and 4. So the vertical points have been taken as 1 dash, 2 dash to the upper end of the minor axis, and all the horizontal points, that is, it is named as 1, 2 and 3 of the minor axis. Next, then extend the D1 line up to C1 and mark that as point. Similarly, D2, D3, D4 lines to C2, C3, C4 lines, and mark them all, and we get a smooth curve. It is the ellipse there. So it is the required ellipse here. So this is the general construction for oblong method. So when you don't understand it in the first method, you repeat it in the procedure also. And next one, second one is the parallelogram method. So this parallelogram method also can be drawn in the same way, but it included say an angle. Next to second one is the parallelogram method. So first construction of an ellipse. So in this method also we are going to construct it by a example problem. So the problem is, the question is, draw an ellipse by using parallelogram method having a major axis of 120 mm and minor axis 80 mm long with included angle of 85 degrees. So the general difference between the parallelogram method and the oblong method is the angle defined in the parallelogram method. So it is somewhat inclined to the rectangle angle in some angle. So the angle is given here. So first of all, we are constructing a parallelogram with the help of major axis and minor axis by the included angle of 85 degrees. So first of all, I am taking the major axis here, length of 120 mm, and name it as AB. Then from the center of the major axis, I am taking the 85 degrees angle anti-clockwise here and drawing the minor axis line in the 85 degrees angle. So that is the basic difference in the oblong method and the parallelogram method. So in the oblong method, you are going directly by drawing the major axis and taking the center of the major axis, we are drawing the minor axis there. But in the parallelogram method, after drawing the major axis line, that is AB line, from the center of the major axis, we are taking the angle here. So the included angle can be taken from the anti-clockwise position, that is from the right side to the left side, that is 85 degrees we have taken here, and drawn the minor axis line here, that is 80 mm long. And a parallelogram can be constructed by drawing the parallel lines to the AB line and CD line. So the minor axis line can be named as C and D. So then divide the vertical line into four equal parts, same as oblong method. So that name it as 1 dash, 2 dash, and 3 dash, and 4 dash. Then similarly divide the horizontal line of the major axis into same number of equal parts taken in the vertical line, that is 4 equal parts here, and name it as 1 2 3. And the center of the parallelogram can be taken as O. Center can be defined by the point O. Then from the 1 dash line, intersect the C point and connect the C point. From the 2 dash point and 3 dash point also, we are connecting the C point there. Then from D point, I am drawing a straight line through 1 to the 1 dash line, and 2 to the 2 dash line, and 3 to the 3 dash line. So by intersecting these two lines, there becomes there and say 3 points there. So we are going to get 3 points there. From the 3 points, starting from A, draw the curve and do the same through to the next end also, next part also do the same there. So taking the number of the equal divisions to 4 and connect the points, that is 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash point to the C line, and from D point connect the 1 dash line through 1 point and 2 dash line from the point 2 and 3 dash line from the point 3. Then we get 3 other points and construct the curve here. Draw a free cant curve from the A to C and next C to B. So draw the freehand curve. We are not using any scale or compass here. We are drawing with the freehand only. So by drawing from point to point, we can make a curve there. And this curve has been drawn somewhat thickness to the other lens. So this is the visible line and we are going to show this curve as ellipse. So we are drawing it as thick. So we are drawing with the HB line, sorry, HB pencil. Next, finish the other end of the parallelogram also in the same construction. And we are getting a curve here. So these are the curve we are getting in the parallelogram method also. So these are the construction for parallelogram method. So we have taken the same steps followed in the oblong method in the parallelogram method also, but we are the difference between the parallelogram and oblong method is, as we have already discussed, that is the included angle here. So after drawing the major axis, you are drawing an angle, we have taken an angle of 85 degrees, that is the included angle, then draw the minor axis there. So that is the major difference, and the procedure also same for the parallelogram method also. The same procedure we are taking here, what we have drawn in the oblong method also. So the precaution is, do not write this procedure on the drawing sheet anywhere. So procedure is for the understanding of construction and the purpose of memory. What are the steps going to explain or construct the procedure is as oblong method or parallelogram method. What are the steps included in the construction is in the procedure. So that is the major point here. So do not write this procedure in the drawing sheet. Thank you.